In this video, I'm going to give you a quick walkthrough of Snowflake, the UI, and really what you can expect to see as an account admin. It is a little bit of a difference compared to the traditional layout of something like SQL Server or MySQL, Postgres, stuff like that. So when you get on here, first thing, obviously, this is a cloud-based provider. So you're actually going to a URL, you're going to a website, not opening up an application on your desktop. Having said that, a lot of the things are similar. For example, the Worksheets button here, you're going to see databases. Within the databases, you'll see schemas and then tables and views and whatnot within there. All of that should be pretty straightforward to anybody who's worked with a relational database before. You know, it's fairly intuitive there. Down here, you'll get the results. Over here, right here, you can see you make some selections in terms of what you're using on this particular worksheet. So the worksheet, again, is where you're actually going to write the code. So you would write your select statements here, select one. And depending on your privileges, you'll get different options. And that will be explored in a different video more specifically. But as an example, you can switch which user, which role you're doing. So depending on that, what you see over here may change, you know, switching back. Now, if you're already on Snowflake, I'm assuming you're aware that the computation and storage is separate. So this is where you would select that. Under the warehouse here, you can select a particular warehouse, which is your compute power. And then database is whichever database you want this particular worksheet to be tied to. Same with schema. So you can either specifically write that out in your query and, you know, select the database and schema, or you can have it here and just have it defaulted for you. But the most important thing in here that's required is the role and the warehouse, because depending on that role will dictate which warehouses you have access to, which databases, etc. And you have to have a warehouse selected in order to run anything. So as long as you have one of these selected, another thing you can do here is actually preview some of your data. So let's say I have this sample model here under my staging schema. If I click preview data, it says requires a running warehouse. So I have that here. If I click this, it will give me a preview, which is kind of nice. You know, if you just want to get a feel for what it looks like, you can see it here. It will also break down over here on the side, the columns and the data types. So let's look at this one. It's a little bigger. You can see all of this here. So now if we look up here, starting on the left, we have databases. This is another view of your specific databases in addition to this. So if you click this here, we can see the breakdown of the databases, when it was created, who the owner is. You can create a new one here. So we could say, you know, test DB and create that here, and then grant privileges as well. In Snowflake, you have to specifically indicate which roles have permission to certain objects, all objects, whether it's a warehouse or a database or a schema, whatever. You need to grant those privileges. But if we go back here and refresh, we now see this is here, and it comes with some default schemas. Next is shares. Shares are pretty cool. It's something in Snowflake that allows you to share data amongst different people and different organizations, different accounts. And a data share is essentially providing read access to a data set, whether that be specific views or whatnot. So in this case, it comes with some default ones, inbound, meaning what you have, your account has access to, and then outbound are ones that you're providing with somebody else. So let's say you have some data models that you've built that you want to share with a client or with some other users or just to the marketplace in general. You know, you could create that share here and then you know, share it with other people. So you would create the share name, you know, which databases, you have to select specific views or tables, and then you would grant permissions to other accounts. The data marketplace, we'll touch on that in a second. That's where you can find basically other shares. People are providing data that you can tap into and either pay for or use for free. Warehouses, again, Snowflake separates compute from storage. So this is where your actual warehouses, your compute, are listed. Worksheets is where we started. This is where you're actually writing your queries and seeing the different objects here on the side. History will give you a history of all of the queries. You can see the specific query IDs in here and who ran them, what warehouse they use, a session, etc. So you can do some digging in there. Account, this will only be visible if you're on the account admin role. This is where you can see your usage, your breakdown by credits. I only have one warehouse right now, but let's say you had different warehouses assigned to different things. You could see the breakdown of costs here. Billing, obviously, you know, what you have on file for that. Users, roles, specific policies, breakdown of session. You could create some reports for resource monitoring. Reader accounts enable providers to share data with consumers who are not already Snowflake customers. Let's say you have a client who you want to share your data with that you've built on Snowflake, but they're not a Snowflake customer. You can create a reader account for them, and it will give them an interface to log into, just like this for them to go into, and then you could share data with that reader account. So they would get their own account number and login information, and they would have their own users and roles and all that. But anything that people would do on that reader account is going to get billed back to you. But nonetheless, I still think it's a pretty cool feature that they offer. One other thing I should have mentioned earlier is this right here, you can also switch your role. So we mentioned before that you change your role here for the worksheet. This is based on the specific worksheet and the query and the table and the databases you'll see here. This role will dictate what you can see up here. So if we switch to analyst here, this thing should have almost no privileges. So you don't have the account permission here. You know, if I go to shares, it's not going to let me see it. You have to be the administrator to see this data sharing. But let's switch back to admin. Notifications, you know, like most other things, you can determine what you want to be notified of. Help, just provide some extra help and documentation. Partner Connect, this is pretty cool. You can automatically connect your Snowflake account with other applications for a free trial. So let's say you want to try Fivetran or you want to try Stitch, and you know you want it to be connected to this. That would make setting up the trial a little bit easier. Preview app. So this is going to take us to a slightly different interface. It's a little more modern looking. Create new worksheets here. And you could save this query as a test. And then you go back and now you can see it's here. And you can just hop right back into it and pick up where you left off. You could share this query with other users. So you can collaborate with different people on a query, put them in folders, stuff like that. So that's kind of cool. Dashboards will allow you to create basic visuals on top of some of your underlying data sets. And this is the marketplace here that I mentioned from up here. If you were to click this, it's going to take you to this app. And this is where you can look at the marketplace of data that people are sharing and that you can connect to through your account. Here you can add some more, some of your settings, and then hop back into the classic view, which is where we were before. The last thing I'll mention, kind of like how we could do it with the shared worksheets here, because this is a cloud-based tool, what's kind of neat is you could write a whole query on here. You could have multiple tabs of different queries. Even though you may completely close down your browser, the next time you log into Snowflake onto your account, it will pick these back up. So you don't lose your query just because you close down the tool. I think to me, that's kind of nice. Down here on the right, you can get some more history as well. So I could say select one, and now you can see the history here. It found that one, run it again. Query ID. So you can dig into that there. There's still a lot more that you can uncover with Snowflake and of how it's actually operating, but I felt like this was a good way to just give you a high level view of what the application looks like if you're new to it, where to find things, and hopefully get you started. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you at a future video.